sheboyganguy.com. I'm your host, David Newton, with my co-host and resident fisherman, Shannon Murphy. It's fall 2014 here in Sheboygan, and the boats have come in off the Sheboygan Marina, and the boat docks are open to the public for fishing.
And the salmon and the trout are doing their annual migration upriver to spawn, and this is also a great time to catch large northern pike in the Sheboygan River, which is my favorite fish to eat. So come on, let's go fishing.
What makes Sheboygan so special to Wisconsin's anglers? Public access to Lake Michigan's world-class salmon and trout fishing. Sheboygan's North Pier and South Pier are two of the largest piers on Lake Michigan with public access and form the Sheboygan Harbor at the mouth of the Sheboygan River. Sheboygan's marina opens to the public for Lake Michigan fishing access from mid-November until early ice out in April, offering anglers a mix of both open water fishing and ice fishing during Wisconsin's wintry months.
Here we go.
We're down here at the Sheboygan Marina. It's the day after Thanksgiving. The ice is pretty thin, so we're gonna use this axe to chop through the ice and set up some holes next to the docks here and fish alongside the docks. There's only about an inch of ice. Give it about another week, we'll be able to walk on the ice, but for now we're gonna have to fish next to the docks, and since the ice is so thin, we're gonna bust through with the small axe. Beats dragging that ice drill along when you got real thin ice like this.
A maul axe works best, and remember to mark off 12 inches on your axe handle, because a 12-inch ice hole is the largest legal limit size ice hole you can make on the marina.
Standing out on the ice. They said there was, 3 inches. That southern wind came off the lake here and pushed all this stuff around, so it looks like we're down to about an inch now, inch and a half.
Ooh, that's a lot thicker there.
Yeah, not much.
Thicker sheet.
Pound rainbow through, huh?
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Going for a 12 pounder today.
That would be nice.
Yeah. grabbed it by the last second. She's pretty thin. Probably got an inch of ice. Jammer in this one here because we got a salt wind. That'll make it bounce real nice.
Oh.
Okay, we're gonna set up our tip up. Got a nice polar tip up over here with some fire ice line on it. I'll put this nice beautiful golden shiner right through this dorsal fin here. Oh, look at how beautiful that is.
Ooh, that's a big one. Got hooked.
Okay, got a little orange bead here for an attractant. Got my lead up about a foot. We're gonna set this baby down the hole here.
Yeah, we tested the ice out here. We got about 3 inches in between the docks, so we're okay to walk on it.
I'm gonna run this guy about 8 feet deep here.
Much of a wind today.
No. First one down, four to go. Okay, we got a, it's called a dog bone. Little tip up. Economy ice fishing, I call that. They're only $8. Walmart special. They work pretty good though. Gonna put another nice big fat golden shiner on this guy here. The same setup on this one, about a foot lead.
No bead
on this one.
Giant ones today. Oh, we need to get put a sucker on one of these too.
Yep. I'm gonna try with some of these golden shiners. We'll put a sucker on the jigging rod. Oh, look at how beautiful that is, huh?
Flexing of the ice.
Oh yes.
I nice jigging action. They're rolling.
We're out here on the Sheboygan Marina. It's late fall. We're out here gonna try and get some rainbow trout, some northern pike, or some brown trout. There's a little bit of ice that's moving in and out right now. One day there's enough that you can chop through and ice fish, but today it's all busted open. We had a strong south wind, so we're down here with our lake rods. We're gonna fish off the bottom. We got some white suckers, some golden shiners, and some frozen shad. I'm gonna set one rod up here. I got some 12 pound test on here with a small split shot, a number 6 hook, and an orange bead. I'm gonna put a golden shiner on there and cast it off and let it sit on the bottom. Golden shiners in here today.
Oh, there's a big one.
Yeah, he's a big one. Pretty good size. I'll hook him right behind his dorsal fin here. Shot on there, it takes a while. It's about 10 feet deep here. There we go. We're gonna hook another rod up here. This one I got a little bit heavier setup on. For my lake rod, I got a half ounce egg sinker with a little split shot to stop it. About a 2 foot lead. Got a number 6 red hook. I got this beautiful orange trout bead on there. The northern really like that, so did the trout. It's a good attractant out here in the Sheboygan Marina. We're gonna throw a sucker on this guy, see if he can't catch us a northern pike.
Oh, that'd be nice.
Yeah, there's some nice big northerns in here. Sucker. Do the same with this guy. Let them all sit on the bottom today. Right towards the end of that dock like that. They like to sit underneath these docks. A lot of guys catch a lot of northern right at the end of the docks, or like right real close in here where they come together. Ugly stick here, Shakespeare. This one here also has 12 pound test on it. We're gonna try a frozen alewife on this one. See if we can't get a trout to hit some frozen alewife today. The northern will eat that too. Caught a small little snake, 12, 13 incher the other day on a frozen alewife.
And these you caught in the spring with your dip net.
Yeah.
When we were out.
Got about 30 bags of frozen alewives on reserve in the freezer. Come in handy sometimes. The bait shop's closed or something. Sometimes that happens around here. Can't get bait for the day, so pull out some spawn sack and some nice frozen alewife.
Nice.
Yeah. Put my eye on my rod right up on.
just don't cast with that bell on. You got to remember to take that off.
I've lost a couple already.
For that bell.
On the bottom of Lake Michigan off the North Pier out there.
You can reel them in with that on, but don't cast with that on. Could come flying off.
Well, very easily. They can't take no casting. There we go. Hopefully that we're not paying attention. We can hear that bell and grab the rod before the rod gets pulled in. Seen a couple of rods pulled in off these docks already. Gotta pay attention out here.
All right, well, I'll set up my rods and then let's see if we can catch some fish.
We got a little display of spoons out here that we like to use. When you're casting, you want to use a nice snap swivel. It's got a little barrel swivel on there, so it can move, it doesn't tangle up. It just opens up, it's got a little hook. Put your lure on there or your spoon and snap it shut.
We learned a hard lesson this year where we had the cheaper swivels. We switched over to these because we lost the big king.
Yeah, the snap failed. The swivel failed. Came undone. So now we use this little hook setup. And here we got a little display of the spoons and lures that we like to use. We got some Castmasters here, a silver and a blue one. The salmon and the trout really like that. We have a glow-in-the-dark moonshine lure. The salmon and especially brown trout really like to glow-in-the-dark for some reason. We got a Cleo spoon here. Those work really well. We got some, this is a Wonder Bread spoon from Jeff's Tackle at the wharf in Sheboygan. That one works really well. It's one of my favorite.
We had a lot of success with that one this year.
Yes, we did.
Caught all our kings on that one.
Yeah, 25-pounder.
Glow-in-the-dark.
That is a glow-in-the-dark. They make two different models. One's a 3-hour glow-in-the-dark, and one's a continuous glow-in-the-dark. And this is an oil slick. Those work pretty good, too. The rainbow's like that. And we got a stick bait here. A lot of guys are using stick baits now. They're really effective in the fall when the salmon are staging and running. And we got some spinners. The spinners work well. You want to have a little bucktail on there. It seems to work the best. For some reason, they like a little hair on there. And that's give you a good idea on what we like to use.
Now these, you got the Cast Champ, the Cast Master. What's this other one here? The Browns really like that one.
This is it's called the Moonshine.
The Moonshine.
That's a glow-in-the-dark tool.
The Cleo, another glow-in-the-dark. We had a lot of success from. We call it the Wonder Bread. Oil slick, your spinners, stick bait, and they come in various different colors and sizes you want to try.
Yeah, different weights, all the way down to 1/4 ounce for like the Castmaster and the Cast Champ, and like Cleos and stuff, they'll come anywhere from 1/2 ounce all the way up to 3/4.
So just keep switching colors and sizes out here.
Correct. It varies by day on what color they want sometimes. Other times it's just, they're just hungry and they'll take it.
Well, all right.
Switch up your colors as often as possible if you ain't catching no fish.
We're rolling.
Oh, there we go. Coming in the shore. Oh, there we go. Ooh, that little trout.
Ooh, a nice trout.
Spots. It's not the sea for Ellen.
Woo! Beautiful.
Yeah, baby. That was a nice little hit on there. Yeah, beautiful. Look at those nice orange dots. A nice little brown trout. Years ago, they used to have more of an orangish red dot.
Well, they're all different colors.
Yeah, that's true.
Depends on the water temperature or season.
Oh, that's a male. It's already got the little hook.
Oh yeah.
Look at that. It's already got that little hook going on. Barely hooked him, huh? Just on the, look at that, he's been hooked before.
Oh yeah, and he's got a scar.
Oh yeah. That jaw's been ripped on already. All right. Nice little brown trout. Domestic brown.
Beautiful. job.
Yeah, look at that guy. He's beautiful little domestic brown.
Yeah, nice colors.
Yeah, nice color. These are getting less and less. Usually they don't start getting that hook when they're this small, though.
That's a wild rose brown.
Is it?
Yeah, that's the domestic brown, the wild rose.
Look at how flat that nose is.
Yep, it's a male. He's starting to get his kipe.
Awesome.
Good job. Now we gotta get some more.
Well, I guess that one paid off, huh?
Sure did.
I guess that one paid off. They didn't even hit the bottom good. Just adjusted it, you know, like, what's that? I'm like, ooh, I hit.
Nice.
Awesome.
Alright, let's get another one.
Yeah. Let's get a rainbow, too. He swallowed that thing whole.
Hungry.
Oh yeah. Is it a fish? We got some nice big golden shiners in here today. How beautiful those are.
They're nice and big.
Yes, they are. This is a smaller one. There's some real big ones in there.
Well, what's your setup here today?
I am fishing what a 12-pound test. From the lake off the piers this year. Got a number 6 hook with a little orange bead. And I'm fishing with this split shot off the bottom. It's got about a 20-inch lead.
We're down here in the Sheboygan Marina today.
Yeah. We're gonna give this another shot here.
Mid-November. I didn't have the camera on the whole time I've been filming here. We got one. But I think the camera wasn't running, so we're just filming now.
Look at him. Oh, there he goes. Look at him go. Turn your fingers. Gotta hold that loosely. Oh, there he goes. He is not done. Yep, there he goes. Oh, he's a... Oh, boy. He's a nice one. Oh, look at him do circles around that hole.
Sure, he does not want to come in.
Oh, he's trying.
There he is, close. Oh, is he beautiful.
Oh, there he is.
Beautiful pink. I see the pink right through the ice.
Oh, there he goes. I seen him up there.
Yeah, I can see a beautiful pink stripe through the ice.
Look at him go. Look at him go. He is not... Oh. Oh. Yeah, he's got some tug to him.
And he's got a beautiful pink stripe going down his side.
Oh, let him go. He's peeling his... They're the masters at spitting the hook.
Yes, they are.
Rainbow trout spit a hook in a second. Oh, there he goes. Oh, there he is underneath the ice.
Can see him under the ice.
Oh, oh, no. Doesn't want to come up. Oh. Uh-oh, he's going to spit this.
Oh, is he beautiful.
Uh-oh, we barely got him hooked. Oh, what? There he goes. Oh, there he's spooling me out again. Yep, we're going to have to gap this guy. Oh, that's beautiful. Sketchy fishing here. Got about a half inch of ice here. He's ripping that.
He is big.
Yeah, he's nice size. I hope it's a female.
Yeah, we need some trout spawn.
Oh, took off. Oh, there he goes again. Oh, doesn't like the look of that gap, huh? Come on.
He is so close.
Missed him. Oh, let him go now. No, he doesn't want nothing to do with this hole.
Got him.
Oh, look at that beautiful fish, huh?
Is that beautiful?
Woo! That's what you come to Sheboygan, Wisconsin for right there. Look at that, huh?
Wow.
Look at that beautiful coloring on there. Woo-wee. Oh, is that beautiful. He swallowed that
beautiful
completely.
Colors.
Oh, he took that completely. Yep. Woo! One cold fish.
That is beautiful.
That is one cold fish.
Wow.
That is gorgeous. Ooh. That thing is happy.
Is that beautiful?
Yeah, beautiful. Huh?
Wow. We finally got our rainbow.
Look at the color on that gill. Beautiful rainbow right through the ice. Sheboygan Harbor. 2 days after Thanksgiving.
Wow. Two days of hard fishing and we got a beautiful rainbow.
What time?
And that is not a steelhead. That is a rainbow trout.
Kiss the fish, babies. Look at that beautiful marking on the gills, huh?
That is nice.
Gorgeous.
Beautiful red markings on there.
Oh, it's a nice one.
Going under the dock again? Yeah, I would walk way out on that dock. Tangle up in this line here.
Sure.
This one right here.
That's all right. All the open.
Okay. He's going to be a keeper. He looks to me like he's 26.
I hope so. I
yep.
Could use some fillets. Northern pike is on the menu tonight. Oh, he's close. Oh, no, he ain't done. Oh, look at him go. He is not done. Woo! Got a little burst of energy there, babies, huh? The golden shiner off the bottom.
Nice. Thinking it's right
yep.
there, keeper.
Yep, that's a keeper. We're gonna have to pull him in a little further. I'll grab the net if you want.
Okay.
He'll be plopping off this dock. We gotta get him in the middle there where there's more room, you know?
Yeah.
If I try to unhook him, he's gonna plop right off this dock real fast. A little belt come in handy, huh?
It sure did.
Oh, is he beautiful, huh?
Yeah.
Look at that nice blue coloring on this guy.
Oh, he liked that orange bead.
Yes, they do. Yeah, I think he's a keeper. Look at that, barely hooked, huh?
Hooked in a great spot, though.
Yeah.
Right in the side of the
jaw. Yeah, you can't snap the line in. I only got 12-pound test on this line, which is plenty. But those northerns, they cut right through that. He's got my finger. Ah, let it go.
Ooh.
Yeah, he's not happy. Look at that nice chartreuse in there, huh?
Yeah.
Awesome.
You got a nice northern.
Oh, that's beautiful. Ooh. He's got some really sharp gills in there. They usually do. That little monster, huh?
Yeah, we could wait for that picture. Oh, is that nice?
Yeah, look at those eyeballs, huh?
Nice northern.
They don't want to open that mouth. They got such a strong jaw. That's not bad at all. Heck yeah, nice little northern.
Nice northern out of Sheboygan Marina.
Yes, it is.
Looks like it's just 26, 27 inches. Out of breath, we ran so far. Just switched it up from a sucker to a golden shiner.
That's not ready to come out yet.
Looks like 25 inches, 26. It just looks like it's just a keeper, maybe.
That's what they gotta be.
26. It's just a keeper again.
Ooh, just in time. Snap my hook. Snap the line. Oh, we'll be able to tell. I got this fisherman on the scaff here.
I think he's just a keeper. Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah, plenty.
Just a keeper.
I got that at 26 and a half. Just enough.
Nice.
There we go. Got some fillets.
Yeah, we just switched it around. Took that sucker off and put that golden shiner on.
Yeah. Works solid. It's got some beautiful coloring to them. Got some pinking on them. A little bit of pinkish and some blue and some purple.
No, what is it?
What do we got here? Oh, he hit hard.
We got to get the net.
Woo! Finally! There he is. Oh, it's silver. Come on, baby! Oh, he ain't done yet. Look at him go.
Oh, boy. That's a trout. I think that's a steelhead. It's skinnier. I think it might be a steelhead.
I only seen the silver strike.
Okay, I gotta grab the net so we can follow. Struck by a northern,
yeah,
we thought.
I was messing around with it, trying to see. Oh, yeah, there he goes. Oh! There it is. See it?
Oh, yeah.
There
I think it's a steelhead. I'm not sure.
Oh, that'd be nice. I ain't caught a steelhead all year. That would be awesome. He's not tired, though. Oh, there he goes.
That's a beautiful fish.
Yeah, he's taking another run. Oh, there he goes. Look at him go. Woo!
I don't know, that could be a salmon.
I don't know, I can't tell, but don't get up underneath those rocks, baby. We wanna take you home. There it is. Pick up this net. See if we can. There it is.
Think it would be better if I net him for you?
Nope.
I think it's a steelhead.
I don't know. Looks like a sea pearl to me. Oh, he's not done yet. No.
I would wait with that net yet.
Oh, look at him go. He's trying to shake that off.
I would wait with that net, maybe.
I almost lost him. Let him tire him out. Oh, we're going to have to move down here. He wants to keep cruising. We got him. We got him hooked pretty good in the side of the jaw. Look at that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, baby. He ain't giving up, though.
He's a nice size.
Yeah, he's not bad. Beautiful. Beautiful fish. Uh-oh. There he goes. He is not ready to come in.
I'm gonna have to net him for you.
I think I got it. He's getting to that point.
I think it's better if I net him, maybe.
I got it. Here, I'll let this dude hang out for a little bit. Oh, it's beautiful. He is not tired. Lost him.
Yep, I told you should let me net him.
Lost him.
Okay, get him here.
Lost him. Oh, there he is, though. Still got him. He's tired now. Got to get ourselves a nice spraybill net. It's a big largemouth.
There we go. Now I'll give him to you.
That's a beauty. Beautiful. huh?
That is beautiful.
Oh. Yeah, I don't know. Kind of looks, I don't know. What do you think? That ain't no sea for Ellen.
Well, it does.
Got a little jackjaw. He's got some of the spots. Oh, this one's hard to identify.
Yeah, because his tail isn't that flat either.
No.
Well, there it is. Yeah, it is flat. And he does have some X markings on him. I guess you're right. That might...
It looks like a sea furlong to me.
It could be a sea furlong.
He's got the white mouth. Look at that big old white tongue. Nice little trout.
Yeah.
Either way.
I guess we're going to have to say that is a sea furlong here.
Well, we're going to have to... There we go. Oh, he hit nice, huh? What a beautiful fish.
Is that beautiful?
Heck yeah, huh? That's awesome.
Wow.
Yeah, baby. That's what we came down here for. Right there. Beautiful trout fishing.
Is that nice?
Yes, that is. Let's get one over
That's
here.
A beauty.
Maybe we get the lighthouse in there. Woo!
All right. This is late fall fishing. We're
yes,
out on North Pier.
Beautiful.
What is it, December 14th?
It is the 14th.
Sunday.
Got another week to the winter solstice, December 21st.
That is nice.
At first I thought it was a northern pike because there was just a big 12-inch sucker floating on the top with blood on it. It was stunned. And I was messing around with that with my lure and the thing just took off. And then two casts later, this is what we got.
Nice.
Yeah. Heck yeah. Look at this nice beard. I don't know. Let's. Can you see that nice diamond rainbow color up here?
Oh yeah.
Oh yes. What a beautiful fish, huh?
What'd you catch that on though?
Caught that on the glow-in-the-dark Mr. Little Cleo.
See that.
Right here we go. It's all tangled up. The Little Cleos.
Oh. Oh, just hold it. We'll look at it.
There you go. That's what it's on.
Is that 3/4 ounce glow-in-the-dark Cleo?
That is a 3/4 ounce.
Nice.
Beautiful lure. All trout like that. Rainbow trout, brown trout.